Exchange rate volatility is increased when central banks are facing strikingly different economic challenges. In the U.S., the challenge is the inflation impulse from the massive pandemic fiscal stimulus supported by the asset purchases of the Fed. The fiscal stimulus is in the past, and the Fed is raising rates and shrinking its balance sheet. But demand-driven inflation does not have an on-off switch and may take considerable time to subside, even after the sources of the inflation impulse have been removed. Europe's inflation problem is more supply-driven than in the U.S., with natural gas and electricity prices soaring due to the Russian-Ukraine war. Moreover, supply shocks make the likelihood of recession much higher in Europe than in the U.S. There's little a central bank can do about supply-side inflation. And with recession looming, the European Central Bank has lagged the Fed and allowed the policy differential to be reflected in the dollar to euro exchange rate. The UK faces many problems similar to those in Europe, with the inflation being supply shock driven and focused on electricity and natural gas. Unfortunately for the UK, the inflation pressure is even higher and probably more pervasive than in Europe. The Bank of England has responded by raising rates, more than the ECB and less than the Fed. At the same time, the UK is planning some large tax cuts to help the consumers. This fiscal monetary combination has fed through to a depreciation of the British pound relative to the US dollar. Japan has not seen the kind of inflation being observed in the US, Europe, and the UK. Moreover, after decades of deflationary psychology by Japanese consumers, the Bank of Japan is welcoming a bit of inflation and has steadfastly maintained its zero rate and yield curve control policy. The possible trigger for a shift in Bank of Japan policy might occur depending on the extent of the depreciation of the Japanese yen. Japan is a commodity importer, and commodities are priced in U.S. dollars, so the currency weakness is starting to impact the economy. China faces completely different challenges. The COVID zero policy and various partial shutdowns of cities has greatly depressed consumer demand. The worsening debt problems in the property sector have also made consumers more reluctant to spend. China is pushing new loans into the economy to stimulate infrastructure construction projects, and the People's Bank of China has made incremental cuts in interest rates. All of these factors have contributed to the depreciation of the yuan against the U.S. dollar. With central banks from the major currencies facing different economic challenges, it's no wonder that policy responses have diverged, which can make for considerable exchange rate volatility.